welcome. Thank you all for coming to the first annual Managing Directors Awards for Performance. My name is Catherine Lamb. I am the director of PhillyStat. I'm going to be emceeing the event for today. Today we will be giving out 14 different awards recognizing the departments that report to the Managing Director, currently report directly to the Managing Director. We will also be giving out 3 special recognitions for various reasons. So with that, I will tell you more about the program as we get into the awards later on, but first, I would like to introduce Rich Negrin, the city's managing director, to start us off with a few words.
Good afternoon. There's gifts up here. I'm guessing they're for me. No? Okay. Somebody asked me yesterday, this is a really great thing, doing these awards. How long have we been doing that? I said it's the first time and it might be the last time. So I'm actually really excited about this. You know, there's something to be said about formally recognizing our folks. This is about culture. There's something to be said about saying thank you. And that's what today is about. That also means that we can do that, but also have fun, right? So some of this is going to be unscripted. Some of it's going to be longer than it should have been. Some of it's going to be goofy at times. But this is about us getting together as a family, right? This is the MDO family. If it's as dysfunctional as my extended family, then we're doing OK. And that's my segue to say my wife is here. So stand up, honey. Karen McCurry. I'm going to fake that dearly later. In his inaugural address a few weeks ago, the mayor talked about imagining what a city would look like if we kept our promises to our kids, if we achieved at high expectations, at high levels for our children, if our citizens took everything from public safety to holding ourselves accountable in our own families as seriously as they should, what a phenomenal city we would be. I'm asking you today to do something very similar. I want you to imagine what our city would look like if each and every department that's in this room performed at its optimal level, setting high expectations and achieving excellence across the board. Our ability to do that is there. The will to do that is there. The capacity, the talent, the people in the room to make that happen is right here. And I believe that's where we can go. And I think that's where we're headed. That's why I'm proud to do this today. This is about recognizing that we have a long way to go. There's work that needs to be done, and that we're not even close to being where we need to be. But that there's excellence that occurs every single day in different ways. And we're going to recognize that, because we know that there are heroes in this room and out there working in the streets every day, just like we have heroes in our neighborhoods who are working for the citizens of Philadelphia from the moment they wake up in the morning until the moment that they go to bed exhausted in the evening. Whether it's, you know, I met with a police officer who, you know, has that energy, that enthusiasm to be the person who runs into the door when shots are fired. Just this week, I saw a firefighter who renewed, you know, my spirit, went into a burning building to save a family. The fire chased him up the stairwell, engulfed the building. He was forced to jump out the third story window. Broken vertebrae, burns all across his arms, burns on his back. I walked in. He smiled, saw who I was, lifted his arm, and gave me a pound. You know, those are the people who work in the city of Philadelphia, right? That's who in order for us to do what we do, whether it's fleet, whether it's public property, we enable those folks who directly impact the lives of citizens every single day. Kat's looking at me like he's really off script. But this is really about the fact that we all know that we're in harsh economic times. And we all know that we'd like to be able to give bonuses, we'd like to be able to reward our employees financially, and we don't have that ability. In the private sector, I can remember the days when bonuses were a significant part of my income. I can remember the days when the top performers went on vacation with their whole family because of what they accomplished that year. When I tell you I wish I could do that for all of you, please believe that. But we can't. So all we can do is embarrass you on television, say thank you, and give you an award. So that's why we're here. The high levels of performance that I expect and where we need to go as an organization are all about culture. And that's about service leadership. It's about excellence. It's about continuous improvement. It's about one of my favorite words, teamwork. When you look at the departments in this room, one of the things that I am most proud of is how we come together during a crisis. We do crisis really, really well, right? Whether it's Adele on his first week, right, with an earthquake and a hurricane, right? First time that's ever happened in Philadelphia, back to back. Whether it's Giselle Jones and her team, you know, working around Occupy and everything that we did around Occupy. Every person in this room had some role in those events, whether it was public property or fleet to make sure the vehicles were out there. Technology, obviously, we come together around those key moments. We come together around special events, whether it's Welcome America, a championship parade, which we need more of, a presidential visit. We come together to make sure people are safe during those events. We come together every day to make sure that our public servants can serve citizens of Philadelphia. So today, for the first time, we're coming together to celebrate. Not because we're done, but because we have a long way to go. And this is my way of saying to all of you, thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much for that. First off, before we get started, I wanted to thank Rich again, or thank Rich, we haven't thanked him again, for really being having the thought and the purpose to put this together to recognize everybody. So with that, I'd like to give the managing director a round of applause. Our first award is the award for operational excellence. And operational excellence doesn't necessarily mean that a department is running well. It means that a department sets targets for key operational metrics, bases those targets on industry standards, and meets or exceeds those performance goals. The winner of this year's Operational Excellence Award has rigorously set ambitious goals, consistently met them year after year, and has literally kept Philadelphia government moving forward. Indeed, this department has impressively met their target goal of 90% vehicle availability 3 years running. If I'm not giving that away, I would like to announce the award for operational excellence to the fleet management.
Looking for adventure in whatever comes our way.
Now accepting the award for general. I'd like to have Jim Muller and his team come up.
Thank you. I'm honored to be presenting the Excellence in Human Resources Award. And anyone that knows me knows I started out in central personnel way back when. So I feel very honored to actually give this award. Certain qualities characterize departments that show excellence in human resources. A high proportion of staff with current performance evaluations, low sick leave usage, and careful succession planning. Just as importantly, these departments bring out the best in their employees and make use of all the talent that these employees have to offer. This department has worked hard to evaluate its employees' performance and to plan for the future. Over 94% of their employees have current performance evaluations. Our target is 80%, so that's 14 points above where we need to be. Moreover, it has internalized a culture of teamwork and continuous improvement. Please join me in congratulating the winner of this year's Human Resources Excellence Award, the Department of Public Property.
Our next award, the Customer Service Excellence Award, is something that has been really, customer service has been a major initiative of the Managing Director's Office this year. And in providing customer excellence, in providing excellence in customer service, a department must set targets for key customer service metrics, base those targets on industry standards, and meet or exceed its performance goals. One of our departments goes above and beyond making customer service the core of its mission. They not only take care of the citizens' needs quickly, accurately, and efficiently, they keep customers happy by meeting or exceeding expectations 93% of the time. It is with great honor that I like to award the Customer Service Excellence Award to the 311. Disco ball.
Call me. Hello, me again. Okay. I'm here to award the Financial Excellence Award. To achieve financial excellence, a department must have a track record of remaining within budget, creatively adapting to challenging financial times, as we all know, and prudently managing departmental resources. The winner of this year's Financial Excellence Award exemplifies this ideal, consistently manages its financial resources across spending classes, and has clearly demonstrated the possibility of doing more with less. Congratulations to the Office of Human Resources.
As a city, we continually look for new ways to improve our operations and enhance the services we provide to our citizens. A key element of this effort is the innovative use of technology by our administrative departments. Not just the use of technology, but thinking of how to use it innovatively. Or IT would always win, and that just wouldn't be fair. with an eye to the future and to the past, this department embarked on an ambitious initiative to improve mobile access to the city's cultural and historic resources. With this new project to deliver point and view access to photos from over 500 historical sites for any Philadelphian with a mobile phone, the Department of Records is the clear winner of this year's Excellence in Innovation.
Hello, I'm here to give an award to whoever came up with this soundtrack. I'm very impressed. No, seriously. I'm Catherine Gajewski. I'm the director of the Mayor's Office of Sustainability, which was created by Mayor Nutter about 4 years ago. And when the mayor first came into office, he challenged us to become the greenest and most sustainable city in the country. We are making great strides towards the city's GreenWork Philadelphia Sustainability Plan. And one department here has been particularly key in helping us to achieve our success there. Thanks to the work of this department, we have a number of initiatives underway to support the GreenWorks Target 1 goal of reducing city government energy consumption by 30%. They are helping the city to lead by example and to marry sustainability with core department functions. Congratulations to the winner of the Sustainability Award, the Department of Public Property.
When I think it could be nicer, being red or yellow or gold or something much more colorful like that.
Our next category, the most improved department. When Mayor Nutter came into office, he set some goals for our city as it relates to how our city government can work more efficiently, effectively, with responsiveness and integrity. The winner of the most improved department knew it had a central role to play in this mission. It set short and long-term goals as part of its strategic planning, and department leaders have demonstrated true progress in meeting those goals at its quarterly PhillyStat sessions. As a result, I am proud to announce this year's winner for the most improved department as the Department of Procurement.
As the least diverse person in the room, it's my pleasure to take Angela Dowd-Burton's place as the Excellence in Diversity Award. To serve our citizens, it's important to have a workforce that reflects the rich array of backgrounds and experiences that make Philadelphia an amazing city. A workforce that truly embraces and cherishes diversity. We must also support our local businesses who stand for the same principles of diversity and equal opportunity. No department knows this better than this year's winner of the Excellence in Diversity Award, a department that is currently awarding 62% of its contracts to businesses owned by minorities, women, or other disadvantaged individuals. Congratulations to the Department of Records again.
Especially with the music that we have, nice eclectic diversity going on there. Well, what I want to talk to you about is a little bit about a customer service officer's award. In aiming to providing world-class customer service to our citizens, a number of individuals have stepped up to take charge of this effort. These customer service officers, and they're all from the various managing directors' departments, feels passionately about the service that the city delivers and are committed to bringing that same enthusiasm to others within their department. One very active and dedicated employee has worked tirelessly to help foster a culture of customer service in the Office of Human Resources, which is why I'm very proud to present this year's Customer Service Officers Award to Tracey Bryant.
Today, and she's very excited that you're recognizing everyone in your departments. And she's actually personally, on a few occasions, completely prior to these awards even being thought of, has mentioned to me her regard for the person who won the Employee Integrity Award. But when asked how he would describe this year's winner of the Employee Integrity Award, this individual's department head gave a simple answer: moral soundness anchored by core values. This individual is a person who has been a rock in a department that has faced its share of challenges. His coworkers know that they can always count on him to provide principled leadership and support when times are tough. For this and many other reasons, please join me in congratulating this year's winner of the Employee Integrity Award, Deputy CIO Jim White.
I want to say just real quickly, you know, we're going to see something a little later, but I want to thank Kat and her staff. Francisco's over there working the computer and the music. Kay Marie, Sarah, fantastic job putting everything together today. Thank you very much. So, these awards, I don't want to call them my favorite. But they're ones that I care about a great deal, and I wanted to present some of these. These are about some of our core values. So if you notice, the awards that we gave in the categories, the broad categories, was around operations, HR, finance. Those are the categories that we measure in PhillyStat. So if you didn't get that up till now, let's talk afterwards, because that's why we're here. So it's why those things are important in PhillyStat. It's why you're measuring those things. It's why we're using the senior team model to really drive those broad areas and performance around those broad areas, because I believe optimal performance in those five broad areas make you a great department. So congratulations to everybody who's already won it. Now, these are individual awards and some special recognition. Some of these awards are really around our core values and who we are. So you've seen some of those already, right? Core values around integrity, sustainability, and others. This next one is one of my favorite. Great leadership drives performance. This is a leadership award. A leader in government builds an organization with authenticity, truth, and transparency. They take complexity and they make it simple. They maintain a resolute and unflinching focus on the purpose of the organization. And they bring a confident humility to their daily work. I love that word, those two words. Confident humility. That's what we're all about. One such individual exemplifies all of these qualities and many more. He's a true leader with a very, very bright future. Please join me in congratulating Joe Palantino. Values. Citizen engagement. This goes to a group, not an individual. We all know that our citizens are the heart of our city. You guys hear me talk about them all the time. Not only is serving them our highest priority, but they're the greatest asset that we have in achieving our vision. Today, I'm proud to recognize the program that has done the most to further meaningful civic engagement. This program actively promotes and improves public engagement, collaboration, transparency, and openness in our neighborhoods, all throughout our city. And I'm very pleased to say it will soon be expanding, yes, John Farrell, 20 neighborhoods. Ladies and gentlemen, Philly Rising. Get the whole team up here, come on.
Babies, they have babies.
So we honored an individual, we honored a program, now we're gonna honor a department. Delivering high quality service in government is very difficult, especially when you have a complexity and a breadth and a scope to what you do that is a huge challenge every single day. Today I wanna recognize one of our departments for special recognition that has faced many, many challenges over the past couple of years, but that I believe is right now making real strides to improve into the future. So this is in many ways an aspirational award about how high our expectations are and what we expect this team can do. In recent days, including a few hours ago, which they helped complete prioritization, they have done everything from reorganize their management team. They've set a new standard for how we're going to deal with vendors. They finalized Philly.gov 3.0. That was in the works for years. They got police on email, which was a monumental accomplishment. And to manage prioritization through all our deputy mayors and through our core team in a almost flawless manner is no small feat. This year's winner of special recognition is the Department of Technology. Now, this is the part. This is the part that I've been looking forward to. Because it's really about two special people. We're not going to do a reveal. Joan, this award is for you. So that everybody knows. But first, I get to embarrass you. Today, we recognize a true leader in the government, Commissioner Joan Schlatterbeck of Public Property. As some of you may know, Joan is retiring this June after 39 plus years. I thought I heard a higher number than 39. You just kind of, just round to 40. Commissioner Schlatterbeck started working for the city on May 14th, 1973. I won't tell you how old I was at the time. She transferred to the Department of Public Property as a financial technician in 1984, rose through the ranks of the Budget and Finance Career Series to be a cost accountant in 1988, She was appointed Commissioner of Public Property in 2006 and has done a great job. For those of you who know her, you know that Joan is a remarkable person. Tenacious is probably the word that best describes her. Other things you may notice about Joan, she's feisty, speaks her mind, and is a crazy, crazy fan of the Phillies. Some suspect that the reason she became Commissioner of Public Property in the first place was because of all the dedications for the Philadelphia Phillies, which she enjoys doing so much. She's also extremely loyal, and as one of her deputies put it, she looks out for her people, sticking with you when the chips are down and never throwing you under the bus. That is, unless of course, you are on her list. I've been told that there's an expression in public property, you've been Joned. Right? She knew right away who said it. It's when you're sitting downstream from her in a meeting and she decides to make faces at you and no one else can see it and you have to excuse yourself to maintain your composure. Getting things done in city government is not easy, and having a leader who can keep things fun is very special, and obviously Joan has a great sense of humor and we're all incredibly grateful for that. Joan, you will leave behind an agency that leaves a legacy of buildings across the city that we can all see and will certainly outlive all of us. But you've been a dear friend to all of us. 40 great years. I'm giving you 40. Make sure when that check comes, it has 40 on it. But I want to say, on behalf of the city of Philadelphia and all of us, thank you for your service. Ladies and gentlemen, Joan Schlatter. This next individual is just as special. Jimmy Mueller. Let's all clap for Jimmy. There's one day a year when Joan Schlatterbeck's world actually collides with Jimmy Mueller's, right? In a very, very visible way. It's New Year's Day, when Joan is marshaling the troops to put on the New Year's Day parade, while Jimmy Mueller is actually in the parade, marching, playing his banjo, right? Jimmy Mueller, head of the Office of Fleet Management, while retiring this year after 38 years of dedicated service, started his career, is it 39? Nice. See, he's doing the same thing. This is a plot to get a little more money in that check, that's all I'm saying. He started his career at 51st and Gray's Sanitation Shop as a mechanic, after which he moved to public property as foreman of the body shop. In 1993, the Office of Fleet Management that we know today was created. Jimmy started out as a group leader in fleet, where he worked hard to get the new office off the ground. He then moved to deputy fleet manager, where he excelled in the management of a number of street shops. He was promoted to be the head of fleet shortly thereafter, which was clearly only a matter of time. Jimmy is truly a self-made man, coming up through the ranks to the highest position in his field. The thing about Jimmy that I hear about all the time from folks is his spirit, how positive he is, and how he gets things done. We're going to have a great deal of a challenge trying to replace that spirit, because I'm not sure we can. As a leader, Jimmy is described as tolerant, patient, and understanding. His team said that, so it must be true. He's extremely positive, never gets down on anyone, and pushes everyone to work together towards a common goal. His accomplishments as a head of fleet are many, but two of them are of particular interest. Under his leadership, fleet's back office was totally automated, leading to increased efficiency. In the past 2 years, Jimmy was finally able, after working really hard to do so, to implement lease financing for our new vehicle purchases. Really made a huge financial impact to our city. An incredibly important tool. For those of you who know Jimmy, he is probably one of the nicest people you'll ever meet. You can't talk to him for more than 10 minutes without hearing about his family. It's one of my favorite things about Jimmy. His dedication and his passion for service has been an asset for Fleet. He's a consummate public servant. Ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Mueller. It'll be my honor to do so. These two awards are probably the most important because they kind of capture everything we're trying to do. The first award is called the Managing Director's Award. The Managing Director's Award is focused primarily on our core values. As Managing Director, I set high standards for our departments and their leaders. Through our PhillyStat program, we urge departments to focus on results, guided by a set of core values: excellence, risk-taking, respect, communication, participation, development of our employees, both personally and professionally, and integrity, and last but not least, passion. A department that really has that passion and that energy to show up every day and go above and beyond. These are the values that the Managing Director's Office stands for. And I'm delighted to recognize the department that most exemplifies those core values. This year, there's no more fitting department than Philly 311. Notice she was surprised because she was tweeting. Notice that. This is the PhillyStat High Performing Department of the Year for 2012. Now this one's important because as we take all the metrics of PhillyStat, we look across all of them, including key wins, key challenges, operations, HR, finance, to decide who's the Department of the Year. And this is the big one. It gives me great pleasure to present this award for the PhillyStat High Performing Department of the Year. It focuses on outcomes, setting goals, and measuring progress. And that can be a very challenging task. But our seven administrative departments do a fantastic job of using these performance management strategies to improve their operations and service delivery. This award goes to the department that has been the best overall performer in all those broad categories: operations, customer service, finance, human resources, and technology. Please join me in congratulating the Department of the Year for 2012, Fleet Management.
I want to take this opportunity to recognize someone not as an award, but as a thank you. Without her, we wouldn't be here today. And none of the awards would have been presented, and we wouldn't have had the data to actually present them. She's taken a much maligned program, PhillyStat, and turned it into a program that has changed how all of us manage today and managed our day-to-day operations. On behalf of the Managing Director, our office, and all of our departments, I want to thank Kat Lamb and her team for the work on performance management and for putting these awards together.
And Brian. Well, with that, we ended way earlier than I thought, so that's my gift to you guys. thank you very much for coming. At this point, this is the end of our program, and we have nothing else to give out. So have a
wonderful lunch.
No lunch.